Welcome back. You're watching KTN News Desk. We'll continue to bring you an update of what's happening around the country. But away from Saba Saba, Sunday, 21 people were killed in Gamba of Tana River and Hindi in Lamu County. Yesterday, the deputy president was in that place where he condemned the killings. But Ferdinand Omondi joins me now by way of phone with an update of the situation in that part of the country. Ferdinand, what is the situation now?
Good afternoon. I am right now at the Hindi shopping center, and people are living here in the hundreds. It is a mass exodus in spite of all the assurances that the state has given. A lot of people are saying that promises, which they have now described as songs, and they say that they are leaving this place. I spoke to quite a few of them, and they're saying some of them have known this place to be their home for the past 30 years or 20 years, but then they have to leave because according to the persons who were carrying out the killings, they were being asked to leave, and they're doing exactly that because they feel they are not really safe here. I've spoken to the area chief, the principal chief of Lamu West, who is saying that also people have taken advantage of the situation to spread more rumors. As a matter of fact, there was an operation early this morning carried out by GSU personnel and other government security organs on the back of intelligence or information that there were some attacks carried out this morning. They turned out to be a false alarm, and there were very few rescue telling persons to make sure that they give information which is accurate based on what they have seen and not hearsay. But the bottom line is that there is a lot of tension from all the way from Okoye, that's just at the border of the Lamu archipelago, all the way to Witu. And here in Hindi, people are leaving their hundreds. Buses have been gathering people from morning. And even as I stand now, there are still heaps of persons, their luggage, waiting for the next available bus so that they can get out of here.
Ferdinand, very quickly, do we know where these people are heading to? And have there been any arrests made so far from the last time you reported it last night?
I have not heard of any arrests yet. We haven't received any such information, but we do know that police are combing the forest around because there is a huge belief that the attackers are not very far away from here. So there have not been any arrests made. The people are departing. Some of them are going to the safety of the place in Mombasa, but I have spoken to a woman whose husband was killed last night, actually burned alive. And she said she's going as far as Thika, where there are other relatives there. So there are those who also told me that they have relatives out there, and they're trying to see like some temporary shelter there. Another thing is that people are not really sleeping in their homes there. The GK prison in Hindi is hosting people. We have information that at least 200 families spent last night in the confines of the prison, where they now feel a bit safer than out there.
Ferdinand, yesterday we had the government saying the MRC were responsible for this attack. A little while later, we had the Al-Shabaab claiming responsibility. What do you make of this latest development?
Well, this latest development points to a mix of certain factors. It does look like a terrorist attack, but on the other hand, there are very specific undertones that suggest that there could be some form of cleansing, bearing in mind that persons were reportedly being asked their identification cards, perhaps making some recitations to do with some holy books. But at the same time, there's the other angle where the persons were reportedly being told to leave this area, this is not their home. And I've spoken to Amzei here, who was saying, they're asking us to go, where do we go? This is where we have known to be home. So even if it is a terrorist attack, Bonnie, there is a very strong possibility, as the government is alleging, that there could be some sort of perhaps political or ethnic undertone to it, not specifically targeting a specific community, but just a large cross-section of people who perhaps are not deemed to be here. But this is subject to investigation. Hopefully something will come out. But if you speak to a lot of the people who have been affected, they say they're being targeted because of who they are, not necessarily a terrorist attack.
All right, Ferdinand Omondi, as that report unfolds, more questions and very few answers coming. I've been speaking to Ferdinand Omondi, who is in Lamu, where he's reporting last night's killing in the area of Hindi in Lamu and Gamba in Tana River.